amazing favors over us by giving us this opportunity to fulfill this great commitment and this great mission. Also, I ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to bless the brothers and sisters here and to accept from their endeavors. And I have met some brothers that inshallah I'll carry the brotherhood and the friendship for a long time with. I'll stay in touch. A reminder for myself and you. If you want to know that this Hajj was fruitful, it was beneficial, as the ulama say, acceptable, then compare your life before Hajj to after Hajj. Compare your life after you go back home to what it was before, and see if you're changing. And sometimes we take it for granted that we wait for the change to come. No. Most probably, all of us have at least 16 hours of flight. Take the time to write down the things you want to change. 2 or 3 or 4 bad habits you want to get rid of. Something wrong in your life, you decide that I'm not getting involved in that anymore. Something that you will let go. This is how you feel that the worship of Allah was beneficial. When you compare yourself before to after. That's why Allah has so ahead. Keeps us. That's why everyone has to put that back. Everyone is higher. That's why Allah has to keeps us always in contact with Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He takes us from one season to another. فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ فَانْصَبْ وَإِذَا رَبِّكَ فَارْغَبْ. It's very important to establish one fact before we all leave. The Hajj, if you look in the rituals of the Hajj, from Talbiyah and Ihram until Jamarat, it's all for Allah Azza wa Jalla. It's all for Allah Azza wa Jalla. And you hardly find the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Bayt Allahumma labbayk, labbayk, la sharika laka, labbayk. إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر لله الحمد بسم الله الله أكبر الله أكبر. All before Allah عز وجل. فالبيت بيت الله. وهذه إضافة الشريف. إضافة الشريف. The house of Allah. Not that it's His house. Where he lives, subhanahu wa ta'ala, ta'ala amma yasifun. And it's the house that's called after Allah Azza wa Jalla to give it honor. Everything from beginning to end, Allah Azza wa Jalla. And makes me wonder, after going through all this, where you can hear some people saying, the family is the most important number one thing. Very important to understand that. Very important when we sit With our spouses, with our children, to establish this the fact that we establish in the Hajj. And that is إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَبِذَٰلِكَ أُمِرْتُ. My life and my death, my prayers, my sacrifice for Allah has surrendered alone. And anything comes in my way, I'll put it aside. If it's going to hinder me or block me from reaching my ultimate goal, وَإِنَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ الْمُنْتَهَىٰ. So it's very important to deal with that mentality. The people who went deviant from the straight path, they went deviant because of this. Allah says, from your children, from your spouses, enemies for you. So it's very important to understand that it can be a very fine line. If we really don't distinguish and we don't know how to deal with it, it can destroy us. Allah has put us here for a purpose, we live for that purpose. Anything else comes along needs to serve that purpose. You don't live for your wife. You don't live for your children. You don't live for your husband. You live for Allah Azza wa Jal. You want to please your husband for Allah Azza wa Jal. You want to take care of your wife for Allah Azza wa Jal. Very important. So the spouse is pleased for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. The wife needs to understand that. That's what holds a family together. When they live for the same purpose. When they live for the same purpose. And the same purpose. That's why you will find Catholic families are prosperous and very happy families. Because they live for the same purpose. They're on the same page. We need to live for the same purpose and the same page. But our purpose is different than their purpose. And that is Allah Azza wa Jal. That needs to be understood well. When the father and the mother are on the same page, that's when you get the rules and you produce the children that will make this ummah a leading ummah. That's why Hassan Basri rahimahullah, when he was asked by a man how to raise his child, he said, come Umar, how old is your child? He said, 2 months old. He said, too late. Too late for me to advise you how to raise your child. He said, yeah, Imam, I tell you 2 months old, you tell me too late. قَالَ بَدَأْتَ تَرْبِيَةَ بُكَ يَوْمَ اخْتَرْتَ أُمُّ. You started raising your child the day you chose his mother. And I say, you start raising your child the day you chose his father. Allah Azza wa Jal says in Al-Qasas about the ummah that he wants to give establishment in earth. وَنُرِيدُ أَنَّ مُنَّ عَلَى الَّذِينَ اسْتَضْرِفُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَنَجْعَلَهُمْ أَئِمَّةً وَنَجْعَلَهُمُ الْوَارِثِينَ وَنُمَكِّنَ لَهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَنُرِيَ فِرْعَوْنَ وَهَامَانَ وَجُنُودَهُمَا مِنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَحْذَرُونَ. وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَى مُوسَى Allah Azza wa Jalla, when he talks about the oppression that many Israel were facing from Fir'aun, he said, and we want to give establishment for the weak one. We want to give power on earth for the oppressed ones. And we want to show Fir'aun and Haman and their soldiers from those people they are oppressing what they were afraid of. Immediately after that, Allah Azza wa Jalla, immediately after the establishment of the oppressed ones on earth, immediately after that Allah says, and we have inspired the mother of Musa to succor him. So al-ulama and Tafsir al-Ahl said, the connection between that part and this part is that the nation or the community or the society or the group of people who deserve the establishment on earth, producing such society and such individuals start from the time of suckling. From the time of suffering. Very important to understand that.